What's up, everybody? Here we go. Fat Boys Football Focus off-season grind is about to start right after this.
Fat Boys are back, and you know they can never be right.
What's up? It's me, your boy Yogi, part of Fat Boys Football Focus, and we're going to get into it. So this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to take one draft player, one free agent, and one player that is going to be end of the road with your time as a Minnesota Viking. And to tap it all off, we're going to do a mock with those parameters. The first player we are going to talk about, he's on the thumbnail. We want the meats. I can't go without saying. I'm going to start off with the interior defensive line. We need a lot of help. And this video is going to be about upgrades and what we could do to make our defensive line better. So we got Tavondre Sutt, defensive line from Texas. Right now I'm going to grade him as a second round pick. We do have a second round pick. We don't have a third. So he's my number one on my big board in the second round. I think Kwesi and the front office needs to target Tavondre Sutt in the second round. 6'4", 362 pounds, just big boy, and we need him in the middle. We need him in the middle. All right. So let's go ahead and let's spend some time and watch some Tavondre Sutt. There we go.
Himself and a tremendous call from Shieldhouse. And what an answer.
Oh, and it's a blocked extra point. Here comes Texas the other way. Austin Jordan in control of this thing through the night in Iowa for two.
We got him blocking.
His body and his hand and everything else.
Getting his hands
take
up.
Take care of that puppy.
Blocking that kick.
On Alfred Collins and pulls him to the ground. So it's first down and 20. Brooks in the backfield.
Getting that pressure.
There's Tavondre Sutt.
Look at that big boy. Look at him.
Tyreen Walker is the back. Gabriel straight back to throw.
Taking on the double team. Couldn't get to the quarterback. Still got his hands up.
But it's short of the first down. So again, they get the pressure. That was Sweat. Look at his hands. There's no way the big fell.
You know?
He did. He got off.
Took on the double team. Couldn't get to the quarterback.
Big man. Get his hand on it.
Getting his hands up. Hands on the ball.
Daniel split out wide. They'll go wildcat with McCaffrey on third down. And McCaffrey is engulfed.
Great hand movement.
And look at the big man in here. Swim. Watch this. Engage. Swim. Disengage and then go blow that
got
sucker up
move.
In the backfield.
USC Trojan, one time Pitt Panther.
And I like him on that right hand side because on the next video, well, next, you'll see who I want on the left hand side of him.
on the outside by Justice Finkley. Both guys working together. Finkley,
I mean, teams are going to have to double team him. I mean, he's going to be a force. Single coverage, single blocking on him.
Gets him back.
I don't think it's going to work.
Inside, work on the center lands. I'm going to start here, work inside. Watch him as he slaps the hands down and then gets the rip up.
Works inside.
And engulfs Josh Hoover.
He's creeping great movement with his hands. Line against a very good third down defense, and that deflection ends up forcing an incompletion. That was Tavon Gray.
Yes. Those two that Allison talked about in the open, sweat. Just two grizzly bears, and they love the ball. Round. And they don't apologize.
Howard, quarterback run, deflected
incomplete. His man gets up, deflects another ball.
Whatever he was thinking, Morgan, it certainly worked. Wyoming running into a brick wall.
Standing his ground, still working up.
This is where depth plays a factor.
Putting the double team.
Other guys are getting tired.
Play fake. Milroe immediately pressured. Came flying off the edge. Eventually tackled
holds his position. Watch those guys.
Giving that chase to get into the first.
Play fast when they move to six. Gabriel hit as he throws. Hit from the back and the ball falls incomplete.
See the way he just worked this guy back?
To see from this
watch front. It.
Now that's why Oklahoma wants to
push him back, push him back, push him back. Disengage. Hit the quarterback.
Last week against Houston, All-America a year ago. Slovis in trouble and down he goes in the backfield. Tavon Drake Sweat gobbles him up.
That's what I think we were missing this year.
Oklahoma State loses to be a rematch of what we saw in Dallas back in October.
Defending the run
and trying to run
and pressure with that interior line.
Runs it. Howard. No! He won't get it.
Another great
what
stop.
What a job. Guess who? Tavondre Sweat
by this offensive line. It just got right back in the lap of Howard. He has got
second round.
Kansas State. Jake Strong started the game. Tyler Shuck started the
take
beginning
a look
of the
at
year.
This
and was it
he needs to be a Minnesota
Sweat
a hand
on an incomplete pass, but down and two. Just a straight handoff to Pendergrass, and he gets driven to the ground short of the line to gain.
Even when he gets blocked, he's able to go kick the ball, track
and
it,
behind,
disengage.
Tight end set, and nowhere to go. Watch Tavondre Sweat inside, getting that penetration, fighting off the
running back.
Gotta like that.
Have not scored since the opening drive. James stood up by Tavondre Sweat. And the rest of the Texas defense. What you will probably
need some meat on the inside. I think Tavondre Sweat is going to bring that.
And that looks like on the second surge
on a show. You can't miss him. He's the biggest man on the field.
And there's an argument he's made the biggest impact.
6'4", 362.
He'll get it again up the middle. And this time he is slammed to the ground. Big stick by Tavondre Sweat.
Second and 10 at the 18. They'll run it straight ahead with Giddens, and it's Sweat.
Look at that. Big mother. Mother.
Explosive plays really save the one long
straight
pass.
Mother.
Something
we want the meat.
To do all day long.
Let's
Aiden
go.
Robbins tackled at the line.
It's a fine guru and coordinator.
Now,
getting a little
of course, we're just watching highlights
line.
Here.
We'll talk a little bit more about
but I just want to drop some main for you guys
moments.
To go. Go out, Jenkins, the game,
first down for
film,
third straight game that he's missed.
I'm just here to drop the main that I think the Vikings should focus on.
Ethan
I want you to drop down in the comments. Do you think Tavondre Sweat would be worth a second round pick, in your opinion?
So hard to run.
Do you think the Vikings should target him?
Right on cue, getting off a block and making the tackle. Going to be close to a first down.
Will help our defensive line. Let me know that in the comments.
To go up double digits, that narrow miss on the field goal. Now it's a tie game and a swarming play. Tavondre Sweat got out to the edge. Got Walker to the ground.
Little yard.
Yes. No.
Try yes. Running here with Robbins.
Yes. In for no.
Tavondre Sweat in there first. They've been much better offensively here in the second half.
Tavondre Sweat in the comments.
Straight ahead. Nothing.
Let me know.
Bailey.
Baron Sorrell there first. Nolan Ford sticking a space in there as well. Sweat also.
Sneed off the left side. That surge looks to be enough.
I want Devondre Sweat to be a Minnesota Viking.
Byron Murphy came in as a blocker, and it's a touchdown.
Boy, got a touchdown. All right, all right, all right. So that was just a little bit of Devondre Sweat. So that's the defensive lineman in the draft in the second round that I think we should target. So now we're going to talk about some help for Devondre Sweat, and I think an upgrade and someone we should target in free agency. And we're going to talk about Christian Wilkins from the Miami Dolphins. 28 years old, so he fits in that Boise age range. Brian Flores drafted him. He's been on record for saying how much he loved playing for Brian Flores. Right? 6'4". 300 pounds. He could play on the left-hand side of Devondre Sweat, because the next video, I'll be talking about the edge rushers. I might do that tomorrow or whenever. But we're going to start off with the defensive line and what should happen and what needs to happen. And I think the Minnesota Vikings in free agency should target Christian Wilkins. Again? So let's watch some Christian Wilkins. Take a look. Get down the field. Look at that. Come on now. We need some dogs on our defensive line. We need some dogs. Get them. It all starts in the trenches, guys, ladies and gentlemen. It all starts in the trenches. Could you imagine Sweat and Wilkins in the trenches? I could. Dig in. 3-4 year deal. Anywhere from 17 to 20 per year. Let's get some dogs on this team. Let's get some dogs on this team. Steady going. Steady going. Get to the quarterback. Get to the quarterback. Get to the quarterback. Meet me at the quarterback. Big boy. Y'all let me know in the comments. Put sign for yes, you would want to sign them, or no sign. Because you wouldn't want stout people. Y'all let me know in the comments. I think those are two steps right there. Two steps right there to help upgrade our Minnesota Viking defensive line. First one. Let's get Christian Wilkins to free agency. Second one, target Devondre Sweat in the second round of the 2024 draft. Now, one of the things that might have to happen, we might have to make a trade. And it might be the end of the road for a Minnesota Viking. I'm on the trade them before it's too late to trade them train. And that player is going to be Harrison Phillips. He's had an okay, decent season, but I'm looking to upgrade and get some dogs on the team. And right now, he's 27, right? 6'4", 295. But I think if we were to trade him before June 1st, we'd have a dead cap of $2.3 million because of a prorated bonus. But we'd have a $6.5 million cap savings that we could use towards signing Christian Wilkins. So in this scenario, let me know in the comments if you're yes, that you would trade them, say trade. No, you don't want to trade them, say no trade. Let me know in the comments. Would you want to trade Harrison Phillips to save $6.5 million and sign Christian Wilkins in free agents? All right. So what we're going to do now, we are going to cap it all off with the mock draft. And in this mock draft, our main focus, we'll do a 7-round mock draft, but our main focus is targeting and getting Devondre Sweat in the second round. And we'll just look at all the other grades. But the main focus of this mock is trading Harrison Phillips to see what we could get for him and signing or drafting Devondre Sweat in the second round. So we won't do any trades up in the first round. So here we go. So we got Minnesota Vikings, 7 rounds. Boom. All right. Again, our focus on this draft is to get Devondre Sweat. All right. So just to update what happened, Drake May went first, Caleb Williams went second, Malik Nabers went third, Marvin Harris Jr. went fourth, Joe Alt went fifth, Jaden Daniels went sixth, Roma Dunze went seventh, Cooper DeJean went eighth, Brock Bowers went ninth, and the tackle Fashanu went 10th. So we're sitting at pick 11. All right. We got 3 trade offers. We got pick 19, pick 37, and pick 43. Pick 19 is the Green Bay Packers. Now, I know people don't like to trade in division. That's a big no-no, but you know what? We've seen Kwesi trade in division before. So let's see if we were to trade back. Because remember, this mock is just our main focus is to get Tavondre Sweat in the second round. All right. So 19, 11. They'd have to give us, let's see, second. Okay. All right. So I want a second and a third to drop back 8 spots. And they accepted it. All right. So we're at pick 19. Dallas Turner is on the board. We're going to go ahead and grab Dallas Turner. Again, our main focus is getting Tavondre Sweat. So we got Dallas Turner. All right. So we have two second round picks. The first pick, let's go ahead and get our quarterback of the future, JJ McCarthy. And with the next second round pick, we got him. Tavondre Sweat. Come on down. You are a Minnesota Viking. We got our guy, guys. We got Purple Gang. We got our guy. All right, now, so we got an edge rusher, quarterback of the future, defensive interior. Oh, we forgot to trade. Dang. All right. So I forgot to trade Harrison Phillip. Dang it. Okay. So trade. Let's see here. Arizona Cardinals. Let's see if I can get a third for Harrison Phillip. Where you at, Harrison Phillip? Ba ba ba. Nope. All right. Looks like we might be able to get a fourth for him. Or you know what? Who else needs D line? 89. Let's see if the Chiefs. Let's see if the Chiefs want to play. Let's see if the Kansas City Chiefs want to play. 51% chance for Harrison Phillip. Offer trade. They do not want to. All right. Not the Lions. Let's see about the Cowboys. See what the Cowboys are hitting for. All right, we were able to trade Harrison Phillips to the Cowboys for a third round pick. All right. I could dig that. So we are in the third round pick. We are in the third round, pick 83 and pick 93. So we have two third round picks now when we started with none. So let's go ahead and grab this video. Will come up later, but you know Harrison Smith. So let's grab a safety. And since this is a defense in interior focused draft, let's go ahead and double dip at defensive line. All right. No. Okay, let's get center. Running back. Go ahead and grab a guard. Like we said, we have the meat. We got four more picks. Let's go. Tackle. Ed. Get a tight end because we don't know what's going on with TJ. All right. Hey, you know what? Even though we got JJ McCarthy, it's the seventh round. Cameron Ward is sitting right there. For shits and giggles in the seventh round, let's go ahead and draft him. That way he can be in the quarterback room. If he looks better than Jaren Hall, we keep him. If Jaren Hall looks better, we keep him. About to analyze this draft. Just remember, the main focus in this draft was to get Tavondre Sweat. So everything else is just a plus. But we'll see what the grade is. All righty. Now, Dallas Turner, JJ McCarthy, Tavondre Sweat, safety. Another defensive interior, center, a halfback, a guard, a tackle, edge rusher, tight end, and for shits and giggles, we got Cameron Ward giving us an overall draft grade of an A. We are able to get a third round pick for Harrison Phillips out of the Cowboys. His replacement is McKinley Jackson, but we are able to get Tavondre Sweat as the upgrade. We signed Christian Wilkins. So I think that's pretty good. I think that is pretty good. So the next video will be most likely on edge rushers. But let me know. Do you like this little setup? College kid, free agent, and who we should think is on the hot seat. Be sure to like, subscribe, and share. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in. And guess what? The Fat Boys are back, baby. And you know they can never be right.